What's up, guys? Jimmy from Mountain Bike Travel Review, and welcome back to another episode of Beginner Mountain Bike Sessions with Bryan. If you haven't been following along, Bryan is 2 to 3 months into mountain biking. We are teaching him all of the basic skills one at a time to make him a better, faster, and more exciting mountain biker. More importantly, we just want him to have more fun out there on the trails.
Fun time.
On this episode, we're going to focus on one of my favorite and one of the funnest and most useful tricks on a mountain bike, and that is the bunny hop.
I know this one.
So as Bryan just demonstrated, the bunny hop is literally hopping like a bunny on a bike. It is a very fun trick. It's cool to show off for your buddies, but it's also very useful and can make you a lot better out there on the trails and more versatile. All right, Bryan, you ready to jump into this?
Oh, yeah.
Let's learn some bunny hops.
I need to be out here with these bugs. I need my latte.
Butt back.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, so the basics of a bunny hop. Bunny hop's gonna be in two pieces. The first piece is gonna be lifting your front wheel. The second piece is going to be literally hopping and getting that back wheel up. So it's a two-part motion, front wheel first, and then you're lifting and hopping that back wheel up. Let's see what it looks like.
Way.
So the reason I mentioned the bunny hop is in two pieces because the easiest way to learn the bunny hop is in two pieces. The first thing we're going to focus on is getting that front wheel off the ground, which is similar to the manual video. If you haven't watched that, make sure you go check it out. I'll leave a link above for you guys. The second piece is going to be getting that back end up. For the first piece, like I said, much like the manual video, what we're going to do, we're going to preload our arms, we're going to push off our arms, and lean our weight back, just like in a manual. And you want to practice this as much as possible until you're used to it. So preloading my arms, pushing off, and leaning my weight back, lifting that front wheel. The second piece is going to be lifting that back end, which is where it gets a little more tricky. Now, you do want to practice in flat pedals, just like everything else, to use the best technique. Using clips can kind of be cheating, but the general idea with lifting your back end is maintaining a connection between your bike. How am I going to ride my bike and literally lift my back end off the ground without my feet coming off the pedals? So what you're doing and what you, it's hard to see, but when I do this, I'm curling my toes down and I'm pushing on my bars. And what that does is it creates a pressure between me and the bike. So I could literally lift the bike up like that with one foot, curling my toe down, pushing on my bars, creating this pressure between the bike and myself. And that's how you're actually going to lift that back end up and how you're going to do the bunny hop. Now, in order to get the momentum to propel the back end up, all you're going to do in addition to that is you're going to stand up on the bike. So I'm in a crouch position, pushing on the bars, pushing back on my pedals, and standing up. Now, the bunny hop is literally connecting these two pieces. So you start by practicing that front wheel once you get that up, and then practice the back wheel. And then we're gonna put them together. So I'm gonna lift my front wheel. As soon as my front wheel is towards the top, that's when I'm gonna stand up, push on my bars, push back on my feet, and lift the back end of my bike up to the same height as my front wheel. It looks like this. Now when you're doing it, you wanna start small and it is gonna take some effort. You really gotta preload, push down, lift that front wheel, and then hop that back end up. Now when you're first starting, what are the easiest things you can do? Grab a little stick. First, we're gonna practice the front wheel, then the back wheel. And then we can try the full hop. Again, not very high. You wanna go faster. Now the more momentum you have, the easier it is gonna be to hop over something. So a little momentum. Now we'll move on to a bigger log.
Better log, Jimmy.
Now one thing to note here, I'm on a 29-inch Mega Tower, which is a really big bike. 160 millimeter suspension front and rear. So it's gonna take a lot of effort as my bunny hops get bigger and bigger. So don't be scared to really preload, pump that wheel up, and you can even use your suspension a little bit to kind of help you bounce up into that bunny hop.
Mega Tower.
Good momentum. Very easy again. Front wheel up, back end, and a hop.
You make it look so easy.
So again, you're really focusing on getting that front wheel up, and then that same motion, you're standing while you're pushing on your bars and pushing back with your toes down on your pedals to lock you into that bike. Now we have to get bigger.
Bigger is better. 2 little logs. Oh yeah, baby.
All right, so when it comes to a log that's a little bigger like this, the one thing and the first tip I'll give you is your front tire is what leads the bunny hop. So if I try to hop this and I don't put enough effort into preloading and popping that front wheel, my front wheel doesn't make it over, my bunny hop's ruined. The bigger the obstacle, the harder you pump and the higher you need that front wheel to go. Your front wheel is what limits your bunny hop. My front wheel only goes this high, I can only bunny hop this high. If I can get my front wheel up here, I can technically bunny hop up there. Let's give this one a try.
I believe in you.
Now another thing to remember when you're doing something a little bigger, as you can see, the higher you get and the more you're tucking those legs up, try to keep your weight back. If I go to hop this and my weight isn't back and I don't make it all the way over, I can easily hit my back wheel and get tossed over. So I'm gonna do this again with my weight back and kind of land on it, and you'll see with your weight back, you still just roll right out of it. So again, we're gonna keep that weight back.
Oh, that was easy.
So it's a safety mechanism. By having my wheel back, even if I land on it, it's almost like I'm manualing off of it. So you don't have to worry about flipping over the bars if you're a little nervous that it's too big of a jump. One thing to remember when you're doing a bunny hop, since you need to lift that back end up and tuck those legs, make sure your seat is all the way down. You're not gonna be able to bunny hop really well with your seat up. Now let's have Bryan give this a shot. We're gonna start with a smaller log and then we're gonna move our way up into the big logs and see how Bryan does with some additional tips and tricks. Bryan's on his bike. Bryan's gonna start the simple way. We have a small log here. He's gonna do front wheel first, back wheel. Again, splitting this into two parts to start. That front wheel up, very good. So again, he's putting that pressure on the bars and then pushing back on his feet in order to lift that back end. He's not wheeling, wrong video. So again, he's doing like a manual to lift that front wheel, getting his weight back, and then he's pushing on the bars and pushing back with his toes down on the pedals to lift the back end. Very good, man. A bigger log for Bryan. Nice, and he is now in the full bunny hop. Again, he starts with that manual. As soon as his front wheel gets up, that's when he starts the jump. He literally stands up on the bike. He's pushing forward on his bars. He has his toes down. He's pushing back on the pedals. He's maintaining that connection with the bike, allowing him to follow with the back wheel. Very nice, man. Now, another tip when you're at this stage, and Bryan's probably doing it and not noticing it, when you go to pull that back end up, you can actually twist your grips forward to help get that back end up. And then really focus on tucking your legs to get that back end as high as possible. So a lot of little tweaks here. Again, the same general idea, but twist the bars a little bit, really focus on tucking those back legs. Nice, man, very good. So Bryan will move up to the next level of log here. He's doing a great job. Quick learner, this guy. Nice. All right, so Bryan has moved up to the mega log, and let's see how he does. He's gonna focus on getting that front wheel really high. He's gonna pump as hard as he can. Nice. Now you can see Bryan's weight was back. He didn't fully clear it, but since his weight was back, his bike was still able to roll right over it. So one of the things you'll notice there too is that Bryan didn't seem to have enough momentum. So if he was going a little faster, he's gonna jump a little farther and likely clear that log. So here we go, big pump. So this is kind of the top of Bryan's skill level right now. Really what it comes down to, a little more momentum and just pumping as hard as he can to get that front wheel up. The back wheel will follow with proper form. Man down! Are you good?
Yeah.
So you're gonna crash. That is a part of mountain biking. We'll get Bryan's bike all fixed up and he'll be back at it. Luckily, he seems just fine. All right, Bryan, a little more momentum. Big pull on that front wheel. Let's see if we can get over this bad boy. Nice. Nice work, man. All right, guys, so that pretty much wraps it up for our how to bunny hop video. Bunny hops are gonna take a bit of time to learn. Again, it's a relatively simple process, but break it down, start slow, start with that front wheel, then the back wheel, and slowly build your way up to bigger and bigger obstacles. It takes a lot more force than you think, even watching this video, to push down and really jump over something big, especially on a bigger bike. So if you are learning and you have a smaller trail bike with maybe a little lighter suspension and just a smaller format overall, it's going to be a little easier to learn on. I learned on a BMX bike, which has no suspension, and it's super small, so that was really easy. This bike, you need a little skill behind it because it is a big bike, so just have patience, focus on those tips and tricks that we focused on, and it'll take your bunny hops to the next level and make you a more effective and efficient rider. And you'll just look cool for your friends.
Super cool.
Thanks for tuning in as always, guys. Make sure you check out the other videos in this series if you want to keep learning with us. Subscribe, like, comment, and keep riding. You.
Blue steel. Bunny hop time.
What's up, guys? Jimmy from Mountain Bike Travel. Now it's gonna be